Hi, this is Deanne Rice at DeanneRice.com, and I am going to show you today how to back up your blog manually using the Cpanel. So, if we go over to the Cpanel, the first place we want to go is File Manager, and I have that open, so I'll just go there. And when I open it up, I have it set so that it opens up into my public_HTML files. And if you don't, you can just click this right here and they'll all open. These are the files you want to back up because this is the WordPress part of your blog. So in order to do this, we're going to select all and then we're going to compress them. And I want to do the gzip, and this tells where the file is going to be stored after it's compressed. This only takes a few seconds to compress these files. So we'll just sit here and wait. And there it is, it's done. We're going to close this. Now, it said that our file was going to be in the public_HTML part, which is these files right here, and here it is right there. So the next thing we need to do is we need to export this file onto our computer in order to save it. You don't want to leave this on the server because if something happens to your blog, this file will be affected. Or if everything gets deleted, this file gets deleted too. So in order to export it, we're going to highlight it and click download. Now this will come up. I'm going to click OK. And it's going to take about a minute and a half to download this. And if you've ever downloaded a blog using FileZilla, you know it can take hours. This is a fairly small file. I don't have much on this blog yet. But this is really fast. But I'm going to shut off the video for a minute and come back when it's done downloading and checking for viruses. Okay, here we are back. Our file is downloaded. Now we just need to move it to the place where we want to store it. So in order to do that, I'm going to right click. I'm going to click Open Containing Folder. The folder will open up that it's in. It'll be highlighted right here. And I can go Control C. That copies it. I'm going to open up a different folder, which is this one. And I'm going to go Control V and put it in. Now this folder is in my file for my DeanneRice.com website. I have it labeled with the date that I did the backup so that I know when it was done. And there is our backup of the WordPress part of your blog. Now I want to show you what's in it. I don't want to take the time to unzip that right now, but I've got one unzipped right here. This is one I did the other day, and here it is unzipped. And there's all the folders that you saw back over here. And so that's your backup of your WordPress part. Now, we're not done yet because we have to go back and get our databases. And I'm going to put the databases right here into the same folder. So we're going to go back to the cPanel, and this time we need to go to PHP My Admin. And here you see the databases on the left-hand side. Now I have four databases here. Two of them are for something else not having to do with my WordPress blog. But these two, the WRDP1 and WRDP2, are my two databases for my WordPress blog. Yours will be the same labels if you installed your WordPress blog using Fantastico off the cPanel. So we're going to choose WRDP1. And these are all the tables within that database. And we want to export all those tables. And click check all. Click export. And the only thing is you want to click add drop down table view procedure function event. I'm going to zip it because I like them zipped up. It takes less room. And then click go. This is really fast. So we're going to save it. And there it is. It's already done. Now we're going to go back here and get the second database. There's our second database tables. We're going to do the same thing. Check all. And you can also export right down here. Choose export there. And again, I'm going to check this box. And I'm going to zip it. Click go. Save it. And both those are done. Now, both these are going to be right close together. So I'm going to say open containing folder. And here both of them are. Now if I click Control and highlight that one, then if I do Control C, I'm copying both of them. I'm going to get rid of this. Go back here. And I'm going to go Control V to save them into the same folder I put the other one. Now I have my WordPress part of my blog, both my databases, and my whole blog is backed up. So I showed you how to back up your blog manually using the cPanel. So go back up your blog before something happens to it, like it did to mine, and you lose the whole thing and don't have a backup.